A number of schools came together for Fields of Faith a couple weeks ago in Wapakoneta, and you'll get a chance to see that student-led event Saturday, November the 1st at 10:30 p.m. right here on TV 44. It was a night of passion and some jokes and laughs.
Every story of coming to Christ is great. An eternity of being with God where life is painless and wonderful. That is the ending to your story. Now the real problem is getting there. You know what they say, there's demons and cats and church speakers.
There were moments of laughter that second Wednesday in October, and also moments of transparency.
One professor who decided to reach out to me was just so happened to be a Christian. And that man fed the gospel to me through an email. He shared his testimony with me. And when I read that email, I bawled. Because for the first time in my life, something was true. Something had meaning besides the drinking and the boyfriend and the bullying, everything that's fake that you get no fulfillment from. And when I decided, you know what? I need to test this whole Jesus man out. So I accepted Jesus as my Lord and Savior, and it was like an instant, it was an instant, it was a process, but it was a change where I discovered I needed to start making some changes in my life.
University of Findlay and Delphus Jefferson grad Tim Sanders won two GLIAC championships in track and field and was a four-time All-American.
Those trophies and those medals and those ribbons and those participation awards that some of us get, 50 years from now, where are they going to be? What's their worth going to be? I mean, even 5 years or 3 years from winning some things, like they're just on my desk. They're gathering dust. They're fading. So while these are a great and amazing blessings, and I'm so thankful for them, they are poor in comparison to what I've been offered. And to what I've been given, and I want to share that with you guys. John 3:16, the probably the most famous verse in all the Bible. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life. God offers us eternal life. He offers us an eternal treasure. And the moment you take that, it's eternally changing. It's a treasure that never fades. It's a treasure that starts today and becomes more glorious every single day. The more in love that you fall with Jesus, the more amazing that gift becomes. And him rising from the grave shows us that we no longer need to fear death.
God will never abandon us. And it's just, if you think about it, it's someone who's always going to be there for you, almost like your best friend.